I want to talk to you about the budget and some of your priorities. School safety, I think, was the last thing that we talked about when you were here, and I know that you were really pushing for that.
Right. I was extremely disappointed that in this budget, we didn't get anything done on school safety. First of all, let me just say our schools are generally safe. But when you read about the shootings across America in the schools, people's anxiety level goes up high when they have children in the schools, both the parents, the grandparents. And the Senate Republicans put 15 pieces of legislation forward to enhance school safety. 15 pieces. One was resource officers with a gun to protect the children. Others was a mental health coordinator in the schools, doing a forensic infrastructure analysis of the school, make sure one way in, one way out. Upgrade the windows, make sure the doors are heavy duty, locked on the outside, the nature of that stuff. Safety measures that protect children. And we could not get the assembly to move on it because the only thing they cared about was gun control. And it's disturbing to me the trends that I'm seeing, both at the national level and the state level. What you have is the quest for power. And with respect to the, I'll stay, start with the state. With power is razor thin in our state with Republicans and Democrats. So they want an issue that they think will get them votes to get them power, and maybe they'll be in the majority in the Senate. The heck with bipartisan legislation on its merit that helps the people you're trying to help, in this case, the protection of children. No, about power, stay polarized, we want the issue. That's number one. At the national level, Trump said, "We'll solve the illegal immigration problem and DREAMers. I'll let them all stay here. We'll just ship back the violent felons, and you build my border wall." No, we don't want to solve the illegal immigration problem. We don't want to solve the DREAMers problem. We want the issue so we can gain power. The polarization of America. Republicans, Democrats, they forgot they're Americans first. They're supposed to be helping people, bipartisan way. This was a classic example of the quest for power and not trying to do something in a bipartisan way that made a lot of common sense. Now, maybe the assembly will rethink it and do something before the end of session. I hope so. I hope so. But very disturbing as to the significance of how it happened and why it happened.
Right. And what has been happening in our country, especially this year with a lot of the school shootings? It's just really outrageous.
Well, outrageous. There's people there that have mental health issues, and you never know how they're going to behave. And we always do the best we can in government, but we don't control the environment. We don't control the state of mind that people that who have mental problems. So, but you do everything you can to minimize the risk.